So in the last class, we have derived various formulas for Laplace transform. Let us have a quick look at them. So properties for Laplace transform. What was the definition for Laplace transform? The definition for Laplace transform was this one. That means when you have some function f of t, so this is the given function f of t, and what would be the Laplace transform for this function? It would be integration from 0 to infinity, that same function f of t, and then e to the power minus st dt. So this was the definition for Laplace transform. Then we have seen what is the properties, what are different properties for Laplace transform. So the first property for Laplace transform is that the Laplace transform of any constant function, that is k divided by s. So k divided by s, this is the formula. And the Laplace transform of the function of the number 1, that is simply 1 by s. So we replace this k by 1 here, right? So next we have seen what is this Laplace transform of e to the power at. So the Laplace transform of e to the power at, that comes out to be 1 upon s minus a. So all these formulas you should remember them. Next is the Laplace transform of sine at, that is nothing but a divided by s square plus a square. And the Laplace transform of cos at, that is s divided by s square plus a square. And then we saw the linearity property. It was the Laplace transform of a f of t plus b g of t, that is a Laplace transform of f of t plus b Laplace transform of g of t. So that means we could write this operator into linear terms, right? Next, we also saw what is the Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic at. So the formula for sine hyperbolic at and cos hyperbolic at, they were this one. So we can use this formula to calculate what is the Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic at. So we obtained that to be a divided by s square minus a square. And then we have the Laplace transform of cos hyperbolic at. It comes out to be s divided by s square by a square. So this is what we have seen in the previous lecture. So here in this lecture, we will first see what are various how to solve various questions using these properties. So let me first write down the question. The question is find the Laplace transform of this quantity e to the power minus 3t plus 4 sine 2t and then plus 3 sine hyperbolic 5t plus 5. So we have to calculate the Laplace transform of this particular function. So let us have a look how to calculate it. The Laplace transform of this quantity e to the power minus 3t plus 4 sine 2t plus 3 sine hyperbolic 5t plus 5. So what would be that? Because we know this is a linear operator, we can separate out all the terms. So it would be Laplace transform of e to the power minus 3t plus 4 times the Laplace transform of sine 2t plus 3 times the Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic 5t and then plus 5 the Laplace transform of 1. So here, what would be the Laplace transform of this quantity? Because we know the Laplace transform of e to the power at, that is equivalent to 1 upon s minus a. So here in this case, we have the Laplace transform e to the power minus 3t as 1 divided by s plus 3. And then the Laplace transform of sine at, that is equivalent to a divided by s square plus a square. So we have its Laplace transform as this quantity. This is 4 as such, and then the Laplace transform this. Here a is 2, so we have 2 divided by s square plus 2 square. So the third is plus 3 as such, and then the Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic 5t. So we know the sine Laplace transform of sine hyperbolic at, that is equal to a divided by s square minus a square. So using this formula, here we have a as 5, so we are the Laplace transform of this would be 5 divided by s square minus 5 square, right? And then 5 as such, the Laplace transform of 1 is 1 by s. So this is the quantity that we have. So we can simplify this term. So what do we get after simplification? So we would have 1 by s plus 3 as such. Just a second. So we would have 1 by s plus 3 as such, and then 8 divided by s square plus 4, and then 15 divided by s square minus 25, and then 5 divided by s. So this is the final answer. So this is the Laplace transform of the given function. So next question is, find the Laplace transform of the quantity sine 2t multiplied by cos 3t. So now we do not know how to perform the Laplace transform of the multiplication of two sine and cosine terms. So for that, what we will do, we will convert this into a single formula. So how can we do that? We can just divide by 2 and we can multiply by 2 here. So we would have 2 sine 2t into cos 3t, this quantity. And next, we can write this 1 by 2 outside this Laplace transform, and now it becomes 2 sine a cos b. So it is equivalent to sine a plus b plus sine a minus b. So we would have sine 5t and then plus sine minus t. So this would be the formula after applying the result. The result is simply we have 2 sine a cos b, that is equivalent to sine a plus b plus sine a minus b. So this is the result. So after applying this result, we can again separate out the term. So we would have Laplace transform of sine 5t, and then because sine of minus theta is minus sine theta, so we would have minus Laplace transform of sine of t. So it would now be equal to the Laplace transform of sine 5t would be 5 divided by s square plus 5 square, and then the Laplace transform of sine t would be 1 divided by s square plus 1 square. So we would obtain 1 by 2, and then 5 divided by s square plus 25 minus 1 divided by s square plus 1. So this is the final answer. For the next question, so question 3, we have find the Laplace transform of sine square t. So to calculate the Laplace transform of the sine square t, we know sine square t, this is equal to 1 minus cos 2t divided by 2. What is the need to perform this kind of thing? It is because we directly do not know what is the Laplace transform of the square term. So for that, we first convert this into double angle term. So we would have 1 minus cos 2t divided by 2. Now because this is a linear operator, so we can write this to be the Laplace transform of 1 by 2 minus the Laplace transform of cos 2t divided by 2. So this would come out to be what would be the Laplace transform of 1 by 2? It would be 1 by 2s and then minus 1 by 2 as such, and then the Laplace transform of cos 2t would be s divided by s square plus 2 square. So it would be s divided by s square plus 2 square is 4. So this is the final answer that we were seeking. Next, fourth example, fourth result is question fourth. We have to calculate what is the Laplace transform of this term cos 2t plus 3. So how can you calculate its Laplace transform? For that, we'll open up this formula, cos a plus b. So what is this term? This is cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So this is this quantity, right? So we have this to be equal to लाप्लस ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ कॉस 2t इंटू कॉस 3 माइनस साइन 2t इंटू साइन 3. नाउ कॉस 3 एंड साइन 3 बिकॉज दे आर इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ टी सो दे आर कॉन्स्टेंट सो वी कैन बाय दिस लीनियरिटी प्रॉपर्टी टेक दिस कॉस 3 आउट सो वी वुड हैव लाप्लस ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ कॉस 2t एज सच एंड देन बिकॉज दिस इज कॉन्स्टेंट सो वी कैन टेक माइनस साइन 3 आउटसाइड दिस ट्रांसफॉर्म सो वी वुड बी लेफ्ट विथ साइन 2t. सो नाउ वी जस्ट हैव टू परफॉर्म द लैपलेस ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ कॉस 2t. सो द लैपलेस ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ कॉस 2t इज एस डिवाइडेड बाय एस स्क्वायर प्लस 2 स्क्वायर एंड देन माइनस साइन 3 एज सच. द लैपलेस ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ साइन 2t इज 2 डिवाइडेड बाय एस स्क्वायर प्लस 2 स्क्वायर. सो यू कुड सिंप्लीफाई दिस टर्म. सो वी वुड बी हैविंग s into cos 3 divided by s square plus 4 and then here we would have minus 2 into sin 3 divided by s square plus 4. So final answer is s square plus 4 divided by s cos 3 minus 2 sin 3. So this is the answer here. Let us have a look at next question. So question number 5. This question says find the Laplace transform of cos cube 2t. So now we as such do not know how to compute the Laplace transform of the cubic functions, but we already know this formula. The formula says, you know what is cos 3t? Cos 3t is equivalent to 4 cos cube t minus 3 cos t. So using this, we can write cos cube t as nothing but cos 3t plus 3 cos t divided by 4. And because we have 2t here, so this formula would become cos cube 2t. This is equivalent to cos 6t plus 3 cos 2t divided by 4. So this is the formula. So we'll be using this formula. We would have the Laplace transform of cos 6t plus 3 cos 2t divided by 4. So now we can use the linearity property. So we
don't need it.
Kya keh rahe ho? So in this question, we are to calculate the Laplace transform of cos cube 2t. So I can first use the expression this one instead of cos cube 2t. So, and thereafter I can apply this linearity property. So for this linearity property, what do I have? I have 1 by 4 and then the Laplace transform of cos 6t and then plus 3 by 4 and then the Laplace transform of cos 2t. So now using the formulas for cos at, we know the Laplace transform of cos at, that is equal to s divided by s square plus a square. So this becomes 1 by 4 and then the Laplace transform of cos 6t is s divided by s square plus 6 square. And then plus 3 by 4 as such, the Laplace transform of cos 2t is s divided by s square plus 2 square. So finally, we have 1 by 4 multiplied by s divided by s square plus 36. And then we have 3 by 4 and then s divided by s square plus 4. So this is the final answer. So these are some questions that we have discussed. So now, let us discuss the next property.